All right, let's see what's up here. Some weird, like, Roman-looking structure. What is this?
There are some files here.
Comet, pumpkin, and path. These are some really strange files that I'm finding everywhere.
An article about a new star in the sky. Many people saw this star, but an astronomer claims that the star is actually a comet.
Article about the annual town pumpkin fair. Supposed to be the biggest yet. Let me know when it starts. Interesting news. Seems that a comet altered its path and headed for Earth. The eye of God lights up the night sky.
Maybe the whole Earth was destroyed. And this is all taking place in my mind. In my dreams. Although I couldn't dream because I'd be dead, but just don't think about that part. Not important.
I doubt the circus will be coming to this town anytime soon.
I wouldn't want a circus to come to this town. God, what would a circus look like in this world? Ugh. Can I go over here? I can, but I can't seem to do anything here, so it's pointless. Hello, children. I am no longer a stranger.
These kids seem happy anyway.
Well, they don't want to talk to me. That sucks. Hold on, was there something down here? Oh, there's a building here. Oh yeah, there's a ton of stuff. There's a lemonade stand.
Ugh, moldy lemonade. Unfit to drink.
Ugh. Don't go there. Ooh, can I ride one?
What is this, some kind of sick horse?
Yeah, actually, what is that? It looks like a pig, kind of, but it's, like, green.
A spring pig. Cute. A big, ugly duck.
I can actually ride it? Seriously?
Ouch!
This is amazing. Ride them all. Yes, yes.
Fun. I should ride the rest.
Ooh, back to the duck. Back to the duck. Again. This is awesome. One more time.
Fun. I should ride the rest.
Okay, I got it out of my system. Oh.
Now I have a spring pig. Joy.
Yay, what the hell am I gonna do with that? And what weird noises is this kid making?
His face looks like it's melting.
Ugh.
Hi.
Oh my
What's
god.
What's your name?
Monty Todd. What's your name?
Oh my god, that face is fucking horrifying. Jesus Christ. That is really disturbing to look at.
My name is Max.
Oh, I got a cousin named Max. You have the same name as his. But you're not my cousin?
I haven't seen any adults in this town. Where are your parents? Where are all of the adults?
I have a ball. I can bounce it.
That sure is a nice ball. I used to have one just like it.
Really? This one's mine.
I know. I'm not gonna take your ball. Okay, bye.
This door is locked.
What about the other one? Ah, stupid root. Gotta go all the way around.
No, not there either. Boy, are you stupid.
This door is locked.
All right.
Run down old house.
Can I get in through the window?
Run down old...
Nope. Wait a minute. Was I able to skip that dialogue?
Run...
How come I can skip that dialogue?
Run down...
But not others.
How am I...
That's weird.
Don't go there, Billy. I'll win in 2 moves.
I'm really impressed with how much movement and details in the world, things that I wouldn't expect to move in such an old game, because old games tend to be pretty static. Even, like, this little piece of paper on the ground actually moves sometimes. Like, it's being blown by the wind. That's really cool. There it goes. That's really cool. Another vision.
Deaths worldwide. Experts are baffled as to the cause of these deaths, which leaves us to wonder, can anyone put a stop to the loss of our children?
Feel dizzy.
Alright, so I remember these places. I've been here before. Massive child death. Is that what mother is protecting these children from? The disease of meat that was killing off children? Hi. Bye.
Kid's got an extra arm.
Ooh, that could come in handy.
What's your name?
What's it to you, dumbass?
Nothing. Certainly nothing worth getting dunked in the river over, don't you think?
Jeez, mister. Don't get all bent out of shape. I was just kidding. My name's Dennis O'Toole. What's yours?
Another O'Toole? Alright, so there's 2 kids of the preacher so far.
My name is Max.
That figures. What a stupid name!
Go fuck yourself, you little shit.
The newspapers mentioned a Reverend O'Toole. Are you related to him?
Yeah. He's my old man.
I'd like to speak to your father. Is he close by?
Oh, he's really close, but you can't talk to him.
Why not?
Because only mother's allowed to.
He says only mother's allowed to, but do you know what I first thought when he said that? He's real close, but you can't talk to him? Look at where we're in. Look at where we're at. A cemetery. He's real close, but you can't talk to him. Makes me think that he's buried beneath my feet and dead.
Only mother? You mean you're not allowed to see your own father?
Yep. Mother says that they got to learn about raising us kids, so we should leave them alone.
Alone where?
How dumb do you think I am? I ain't no squealer.
Is that your father's church across town?
Uh-huh. That's St. Michael's church.
I haven't seen any adults in this town. Where are your parents? Where are all of the adults?
Mother took care of them. In fact, I'd watch my step if I were you. After all, you're the only adult in town, and Mother don't like adults.
That's becoming very clear.
Watch my step? I've had enough of you and your little threats, kid.
Whoa! Calm down, mister. I was just telling you to be careful, that's all.
Yeah, well, maybe I'll break your third arm, you little shit. I'm just kidding, I would never do that.
Headstone. It says, Mike N. killed by tainted meat.
Alright, so there's some sort of a meat plague, it sounds like.
C. Driscoll. Missed dearly by mother.
Driscoll, I just heard that name, but I don't remember from who. Wait a minute, wasn't that in the files in the church? The one about the guy questioned, the mother found with her wrists slit, wasn't one of them named Driscoll?
This kid's just a little more than a baby. Hi there. What's your name, kid?
Derwick, what's yours?
My name is Max.
Hi, Max. I'm Derwick.
Yes, I know. I haven't seen it.
I don't know.
Why are all you kids here in the cemetery?
Because Dennis says so.
Okay, I guess it's a good reason. Sure. Bye. Okay, what are you doing?
Poor misshapen kid. What's your name?
Well, since all the adults went away, everyone calls me Lumpy.
Oh. Well, I can see why, but what's your real name?
Do you have another name? A real name?
Well, my real name is Larry, but no one calls me that anymore. What's your name, mister?
My name is Max.
It's not as cool as my name, but it's okay. I guess that means you ain't a stranger no more, so I can talk to you, right?
Right.
Mother says we're not supposed to talk to anyone about that, especially you big people. Sorry.
I think I need to talk to this mother.
I read the town newspapers and saw some articles about a man named Jetta Driscoll. Was he your father?
Yeah.
Her legs are like tree roots.
Hello, young lady. What's your name?
Eileen Daly. What's yours?
My name is Max.
That's a nice name.
Oh, thank you. Alright, welcome back. The game crashed again. However, it's not all bad. So, okay, this means that the game is pretty unstable. Which I'm not complaining about as a flaw of the game. Because, again, it's said to only oh god, that's loud. On GOG, it's said to only support XP and Windows Vista, and I'm running Windows 7, so I wouldn't expect it to be stable. So, it's not unexpected. But it's... the good thing... there's two good things about this. One, it's not horribly unstable. It's been, what, I don't know, 45 minutes to an hour, I guess, since it last crashed. Which is quite a long time to go without crashing. It's not too bad. And the second thing is, I just found something out. The quicksave system actually does work. It's just horribly implemented and gives you absolutely no feedback whatsoever. So right now, the zero key is assigned to quicksave. I'm gonna press it right now. I just saved. The game does not tell you that you've just saved. It doesn't hitch or anything. There's absolutely no indication that you've just saved. Except my cursor seems to actually blink for a second. But yes, there's no feedback that you've saved. However, it does actually save. If you go into load,
load game.
And you go to the last page, so first page, second page, third page, there it is. And if you load that, I should be right back to where I was. So that means I can save constantly, and it won't interrupt the gameplay at all, it doesn't freeze. Yep, here we go. And it's no problem, so that pretty much solves the whole issue. I mean, it can, like, if it crashes every half hour to an hour, that's fine. Because I can seamlessly save. Like, I'm walking. I just saved. Just like that. So, not a big deal. Okay, I think I was talking with her.
Her legs are like tree roots.
Hello.
Eileen.
Alright, what did I ask about? Adults, yep. What else did I ask about? Maybe that was it.
Why are all you kids here in the cemetery?
Our leader, Dennis, likes to play hide-and-go-seek here.
Hmm.
Can I play a game of hide-and-seek with you?
You'd have to ask Dennis, but I'd rather not play right now. I was just going to plant my pretty pumpkins.
You like pumpkins, huh?
Mm-hmm. I like the pretty orange color.
Hmm. Orange keeps coming up. The one guy talked about eating pumpkin pie and getting in trouble for it because it came from the patch. Another kid, what was it, Billy? Talked about something eating, what was it, like a goldfish and pooping orange for days or something like that? And now her, there's just lots of mentions of pumpkins and patches and orange. Weird.
Orange, huh? That reminds me of a story that Billy told me.
Oh, yuck. Did he tell you that awful cat story?
Mm-hmm.
That's gross, huh?
Yeah, just like Billy.
Do you play tic-tac-toe with Jessie?
Yeah, she thinks she's the best, but I beat her 7 times.
Where is your mother? I'd really like to talk to her.
Gee, I'm sorry, Mr. Max, but we're not supposed to tell no one.
Why not?
'Cause Mother doesn't want to be disturbed while she's resting.
Okay, she's apparently sleeping. I just saved, by the way. I just saved again. And again, and again, and again! Got it so quick. Okay, I think I've already talked to... Yeah, I already talked to that kid. Okay. Oh, there's another one there. Didn't even see you there. What are you wearing? Is that like a pirate costume?
The boy's face is mottled and... leafy.
Leafy?
Hi there. What's your name, kid?
My name's Marcus. Marcus Williams. What's yours?
Oh, it's Max. It looks like he's actually wearing, like, a sailor's outfit.
My name is Max.
Hi, Max. I guess you're not a stranger anymore.
Why are all you kids here in the cemetery?
'Cause Dennis likes it here.
I haven't...
Mother made him go away.
Away? To where?
Sorry, mister, but I'm not allowed to tell you.
Alright, it doesn't seem like anyone is going to tell me about the adults. They're very tight-lipped. Alright, so who's Dennis again? Is this Dennis up here?
Now I...
No, I didn't mean to do that.
Kid's got an extra arm. What's your name?
What to tell you, dummy?
Nothing.
Jeez, mister.
Alright, yeah, that is Dennis. This conversation hasn't happened yet because of the save game I loaded. To get back here was old, so let's get through this.
The newspaper... I'd like... Oh.
Yeah.
Oh. Is...
Oops.
Uh-huh.
Oh, I thought I clicked goodbye. I didn't. Never mind. I'm good.
I haven't... Watch my step.
Whoa!
Why are... Why?
They play kid...
Okay, here we go. So yeah, he likes to play. Let's see if I can play.
What makes you think you're the best?
Because we have a secret weapon.
Really? What is it?
If I told you, then it wouldn't be a secret.
Okay, that's fair enough, actually. Very true.
A prize for winning, huh? What is it?
The keys to the town store. There's lots of cool stuff inside. Our fort, our candy, everything.
It's been a while since I played this game. Could you tell me the rules?
Yeah. It's so simple, even you can play. You cover your eyes and count to 10. We'll all go hide, and then you try to find us. If you find any of us, we go back to base, the angel at the center of town. If you can find all of us, you get the key.
Well, that sounds pretty easy.
Ha! You say that now, but just wait until you try to find us.
Oh, I'm gonna find you little shits. And apparently there isn't even a time limit. So I have all the time in the world.
Can I play a game of hide-and-seek with you?
Yeah, if you really want to show everyone what a big, fat loser you are.
That's it, Big Mouth. You'd better pray that I don't find you. Let's go.
Come on, you shits. Go hide.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Okay, okay. Obvious spots. In here and in here. Hello? Damn. Ooh.
A crowbar. Should come in handy.
I can't think of an adventure game where a crowbar would not come in handy. So many uses for that. Dear God, stay off of the sandy parts. Or the dirt parts, whatever the hell that's supposed to be. It's so loud!
Yuck.
Ugh.
A decaying corpse. What a god-awful stench.
It's disgusting. Alright, where could they be hiding? And how many were there? Let's see, there's Dennis. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are at least 5. 5 to 6.
Wanna play again?
Ugh, moldy lemonade. Unfit to drink.
I just saved, by the way, but you didn't even notice. Alright, let's go check in here. I also have another idea. No?
Damn, useless crap.
Okay, there's like five of them. There's at least five of them. I should start finding some of them soon, otherwise... Well, I mean, some of them should be easy, right? I don't expect to find all of them easily, but I should be able to find some of them. Where did they go? Oh, there we go. Really? You think you're hiding? I see you.
Aha!
All right, that's one out of five or one out of six. I think there might be one back here. Because I was wondering why you can go back here, but there doesn't seem to be anything back here. Aha, I knew it. Okay. Hello.
There you are.
All right, two out of five or two out of six. Making progress. All right, let's go explore up here for the first time. Ooh, can I go up here? Oh, I can. Well, it doesn't go anywhere.
A metallic cross. I'll need something to fish it out with.
Do I really want it? Why would I want it? I could try the crowbar. Might be long enough, maybe. Oh, wow. Okay, I don't think I'm getting through there.
The way appears to be blocked by vines.
Alright, let's try the crowbar. What do I have?
I have a spring pig. Joy.
Alright, I have the spring pig. I don't know what the hell I'm supposed to do with that, but let's try the crowbar.
Should... No.
Nope.
That's...
Okay, wow. Big vine. Oh, hello.
Aha!
Gotcha. Alright, two or three more.
The vines are thicker around the barn.
Never mind the fact that I could clearly just climb over them, but... Anyway. Does anyone actually sleep here? This is creepy as hell. Sleeping next to a tangle of vines. I'd be worried that they'd, like, constrict me and suffocate me in my sleep.
A newspaper article.
Oh, it's an obituary. That's wonderful.
It's an obituary. Marilyn Lee Driscoll, age 32, died Saturday. Husband, Jetta. Daughter, Carol. And son, Lawrence. A diary. No name on it, but it looks like a little kid's writing.
Well, this is probably going to be disturbing. Accident.
Here's an early entry. I wish Mommy wasn't so sad all the time. She cries a lot. She says that Daddy drinks too much. Daddy's been staying in the patch until dark. When Dad comes in, he yells at Mommy and they fight real bad. He yells a lot lately.
Yep. I wonder if that's the what was her name? Something Driscoll? The woman who killed herself, found with her wrists slashed? Alright, had another crash there. Let's begin from the accident entry again.
Another entry. Mommy's up in heaven now. Dad said she had an accident and God took her away. I miss her a lot. I wish she were here to stop Dad from drinking so much. Dad smells bad when he drinks that stuff. He gets real mad and he starts hitting me.
Oh god, this is horrible.
Skip a few pages here. Today was a bad day. A big rock fell out of the sky and hit our barn. Dad's real mad about that and all the vines that are growing out of it. He was gonna cut them down, but Father O'Toole wouldn't let him. Now Dad's even more mad because we're gonna lose all our pumpkins.
The vines are growing out of the thing that fell from the sky? What?
Last entry. Prayed to Mommy again today. I hope she heard me because I had to be real quiet so Dad wouldn't find me. He was hitting me again, and it hurt a lot this time. I hid out by the rock in the barn. It's warm and makes me feel good. Sometimes I can even hear music coming out of it.
Oh god, this is horrible. The rock by the barn, that's gotta be this whole thing, right? This rock? But I can't get through because of the vines. Alright, two or three more kids to find. I don't suppose any of these doors are unlocked now? Probably not.
This door is locked.
Nah, the other one's still gonna be locked too. Let's check down on the...
I win again, Billy.
Beach part.
You can't never, never, never beat me.
Down by the O'Toole kid. At most there's gonna be one though, so that would leave one more. Anything? No. Damn. God, that's loud. Okay. I don't even know where to look. I don't even know what to do. I mean, could I pry the boards off with the...
A crowbar.
With a crowbar? Oh, I can. Oh, what the what the hell just happened in that animation? Hold on, replay! What the hell was that? Okay. That was a very strange animation. Okay, well, I'm a Hulk man.
Schoolhouse.
My god. So many corpses. It's horrible.
What the fuck? Oh my god. Rotting bloody corpses in the schoolhouse.
Decayed bodies. Are these the parents? If I asked the kids directly, it might upset them.
Maybe they don't know it's here. Maybe it was boarded up by Mother. To keep it from their eyes.
Decayed bodies. Are these the parents? If I asked the kids directly, it might upset them.
But then what is he doing in here? Why would you hide in here? Jesus.
There you are. My god. What kind of hiding place is this?
Alright, one or two more. Oh. God, this is horrible. Do I still have the crowbar? No. Alright, so I don't need to use it again. Is there only one more, or is there two? Got the girl, and... which one am I missing? Oh, I'm missing the big one. What was it called? Lumpy, right? I forgot his real name. which is kind of insulting, I guess. I forgot his real name, but I remembered his insulting name that makes fun of him for his deformity. That's, wow, that's bad. I'm sorry.
Your name is Dennis O'Toole, right?
That's my name. Don't wear it out.
Don't worry, I won't. Alright. So where the heck would he be? Where is there left to look?
There. And she puts an O on top of it.
He did say they have a secret, right? A secret. Secret. Oh, wait a minute, can I go back here? Oh, whoa. I did not realize I could do that. Jetta's pumpkins. Can I get over there?
A wooden plank. Too far away.
Yeah. Alright, so I can get over there at some point.
Too far.
But not yet. Can I just, like, jump over the gap? I think I might actually be able to make that.
Spring flood must have washed out the bridge. Need some kind of stepping stone.
What about this? Wait, seriously? I did that as a joke. I thought when he said stepping stone, he meant like I just need... I thought I needed like a board, a plank, to bridge the gap. I didn't actually think that would work. Okay, well, I'm not complaining. Oh god, not that loud sound again, Jesus. Hi, are you... Looks like she's wearing a nightgown.
My god, she's half worm.
What? Half worm? So that's not a nightgown, that's what, silk?
This girl's eyes are missing. Was she in some sort of accident?
Excuse me, little girl, but could I talk to you for a second?
Sure, mister. I don't get many visitors.
May I ask your name?
My name is Maria. Maria Santiago.
I don't even know what I'm looking at, honestly. I think she has a gigantic tail? I don't know, and is that clothes, or is that just like her skin is all like white or something? I don't even know. What about the adults? I'm sure she won't tell me anything.
I haven't seen any adult-
I'm sorry, but Mother has forbidden us to talk about them.
I keep hearing about Mother, but it doesn't sound like she's anyone's real mother. Who is this person?
She's resting right now, otherwise I wouldn't speak to you. You're right, though. She isn't anyone's real mother. She's really...
What is it, Maria?
I think she's waking up. I can't talk anymore. Mother will hear me and get awful mad.
But... Oh, damn it!
How would she know that she's waking up?
Forbidden? But why? Why can't you talk about your parents?
Please don't be mad. I'd tell you if I could. It's just that... Well... I'll be punished again if I do.
Punished again? So she's been punished before.
Punished how?
The pumpkin patch. She'll have me put in the pumpkin patch again. It's a terrible place.
It doesn't look so bad from here.
Once you're inside, everything turns bad.
Oh, and I'm about to go into the pumpkin patch, aren't I? Ooh, boy.
You've been in there before?
Yes. The others dragged me in there.
The other children?
They did as they were told. Mother wanted to teach me a lesson.
What lesson, Maria?
Not to look for our parents. Mother said we should never, ever do that. But I was too curious. Mother saw me. She told the other kids that I was bad. Then she made them put me in the patch. I don't remember much, just those nasty birds, black wings. They pecked at my eyes. It hurt a lot. But when the birds were done, Mother took the pain away.
That's horrendous. How could she do such a thing to a child?
It's okay. It's not so bad now. I'm kind of used to it. Anyway, once Mother wakes up, everything will be better.
Okay. What are you...
Please. I don't want to talk about it anymore. I've already said too much.
Jesus, the birds pecked out her eyes.
Where are we? What's the name of this town?
There is no town. Not anymore.
What do you mean, not anymore?
There was a town before Mother got here. People were happy. Everything was fine.
Before your mother came to town? What do you mean?
You're new here. You just don't understand.
No, I don't understand. You're only confusing me more. Could you explain it to me? Start at the beginning?
I'm sorry. If you want to really understand what's going on, I think that there's lots of newspapers and stuff in the town hall. But I haven't seen them. Come back in a little while and we'll talk some more. I'd show you the way to the town hall, but my eyes...
I think I've been to the town hall. Is that the one that had all the information about comets and stuff like that? God, this is a seriously twisted world that I'm in. Just... whatever this mother is, abusing and deforming these children and punishing them for looking for their parents. Just sick. I really don't want to go inside now, but I think I have to.
The gate has a combination lock.
Oh, of course.
I need the right combination to open this. Now, let's see.
Ooh, I've got this one. One, two, three. Did it work? Damn.
Nope.
Alright, can I go around here? Let's go around the outside of the pumpkin patch. And I can't go any further.
A big, overgrown pumpkin patch.
Yeah, it does look like it could use some tending to. A little bit of trimming. And by a little bit, I mean a lot. Actually, those pumpkins just like... are they just rotting? Yeah, they don't look too good.
Not from here.
I need a combination. I wonder if that's what Dennis meant when he said they had a secret. Maybe the secret is that they hide in the pumpkin patch, which is why they always win? Or something like that? Maybe I'm gonna find one of them in there. But where would I find the combination?
Not there either. Boy, are you stupid.
So it was a three combination, right? Three number combination? Yeah.
Then she puts an O on top, and then...
what has numbers?
Put an X on top. Oh, snot.
I'm thinking it might be a date. Perhaps. Perhaps. Something from the diary. Or the... wait, can I read it again? Yes. I don't think it'd be from the diary, but what about the newspaper? If this takes too long, I'm gonna cut it, by the way, so don't worry. I'm not gonna spend like a half hour stuck on a puzzle. But we'll just see what happens to begin with. Let's see if I can solve it quickly. If not, then I'll cut it.
It's an obituary. Marilyn Lee Driscoll, age 32, died Saturday. Husband, Jetta. Daughter, Carol. And son, Lawrence.
Alright, 32, that's... well, not enough numbers, so... no, don't think that's it. Okay. I'm gonna do one more thing before I cut till I figure out the solution. I'm gonna look at Town Hall, or what I think Town Hall is. Look at those documents again, because she mentioned Town Hall specifically. So I'm thinking I might find the solution there. Alright, so I'm guessing this is Town Hall? I mean, there's the school, and then here's the church, and then this is, like, the only other building. Although, wait. Maybe Town Hall is the one to lock doors. But where would I find the key?
There are some files here.
Alright. Pumpkin Pat.
An article about a new...
Looking for dates
article
and stuff.
About the annual...
No. No.
Interesting news.
No. No dates. Alright, I'm gonna cut here, and when I come back, I will find the solution. Wait a minute. Hold on. I was just about to cut, and then I just realized this. Today's sermon, 451, The Gates of Heaven. Can that be a coincidence? Four numbers, and it's about the gates of heaven? It's about a gate? 451, let me write that down to make sure I don't forget. That can't be a coincidence, right? No way. 451, the gates of heaven. It's not funny. It's not funny, Max.
I'll need funny. The right...
Alright, 451. Holy shit, I feel smart.
I guess it's time to check out this patch.
Alright, so what do you bet the chances are of me being able to get through this entire game without using a walkthrough? Keep in mind, this is an adventure game from 1998. I'm putting my chances at about 1%. I actually have the walkthrough. I have it all loaded up and ready to look at if I need it. But, I don't know. I'm gonna keep trying to go without the walkthrough, as always. Okay, please don't peck out my eyes, dear God. Well, that is a scythe. A freaking huge and nasty-looking scythe.
Slice and dice, baby.
Don't get too excited, Max. Oh, you're actually gonna keep it as a weapon? Oh. I guess I need to defend myself? It does make sense. I mean, everything I've heard indicates that coming in here will result in your dismemberment at the hands of birds or maybe something else.
Well, this old junker isn't going anywhere.
Or wait, can I just take this and cut the vines? All the vines back over there, by the farm? Ooh, maybe.
Well, this old...
I can't seem to put it down, though.
Uh-oh.
Fuck you! I knew it! Shits, you little shits. Come on, face me! Come on! Yeah? Come on! Yeah! Fuck all of you. I'm gonna peck out my eyes. I am keeping my eyes. I'm keeping my eyes. You're not taking them from me. I think you'll see that I can be rather stubborn. Come here. What the fuck? What? Run. Oh, God.
Damn, he keeps coming. There must be another way.
Okay, another way. Like what? Cut the pumpkin? No, what are you doing? Run. Jesus. Okay, there we go. Good. I did not think I'd have to fight a pumpkin, an animated pumpkin man. Or whatever the hell this is. Like a pumpkin scarecrow thing? Oh, shit. Okay. Heart rate's beating fast. Come on. Here we go. Okay. What now? It didn't work. Does that make it vulnerable now? Or can I get out? No. Okay. Ooh.
Got him. I guess he thought it was better to burn up than fade away.
Haha, very clever. I just got attacked by crows and then fought a pumpkin patch monster. This game is really cool. It's just so strange. And there's something amazing about something that's just so strange. I have no idea what's going to happen next, and I love it. There's nothing formulaic about this at all. Do I get to keep the scythe? No. Why would I drop the scythe? I mean, I know the real reason is because the game has now told my character that I don't need it anymore, so it automatically dropped it and made it disappear into the nether, but wouldn't you want to keep it in reality if you were here? Why would you assume that that's the last thing you're going to have to fight? What the f... is that? Oh, that's the stone! That fell down, all the vines are coming out of it. What is it?
This rock must be the source of all the monstrous plant life. It appears metallic. This rock...
the heck is that? It's like some sort of a power source or something.
It looks like a barn.
I doubt the circus will be coming to this town anytime soon.
An old gas-powered generator.
Hmm. Turn it on? Why not? What could go wrong?
Must be out of gas.
Okay. I'm not sure why you had to stand there for like 3 seconds while nothing happened to say that. Let's do it again. Waiting. 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 Waiting.
Must be out of gas.
Why does that take so long? Alright, so the car has gas that I can use. It has a full tank. Oh, I did not mean to press that. I'm sorry.
Must be out of gas.
But I have nothing with which to siphon it out. Ooh. Ooh, a board. Oh cool, it gives me a shortcut. Oh yeah, if I didn't have this as a shortcut, I guess I'd have to go through the whole patch again. That'd be horrible. Alright, maybe in this barn, or in this, I can find a tube. Something I can use to siphon.
What a piece of junk. Probably only good for spare parts.
Precisely what I was thinking. Please grab some spare parts, including a fuel line.
What a piece of junk. Probably only good for spare parts.
Or you could not grab a fuel line, that's okay.
What a piece of junk.
Oh, I need to click on this corner right here. I can't click on anywhere else. See? Examine, examine, examine. Hand. Ooh, what is that, a fuel line?
Looks like a jumper cable. Might be useful.
Okay, never mind, that's not a fuel line. God damn it. Are you sure?
Jumper cables.
The hell am I gonna do with jumper cables? I need something that's hollow so I can get the fuel out. Actually, I even need a container. I need a freaking container to put the gas into afterwards. I didn't think that far ahead.
What a piece of junk.
Jumper cables. Jumper cables. What am I gonna jump? What around here even has power?
What a piece of...
anything else I can do with this? Nope. See if I can get into the barn. What the...
oh my god!
Oh my god. Is that Mother? Let me make a permanent save here.
Save game. Game.
What the fuck? I can't help but notice that I'm inside of this little circle that's almost like a noose. I wonder if I can even leave. I wonder if I should try. No, let's talk to it first. Hi.
What a huge, disgusting nightmare.
So you finally arrived. I suppose it was inevitable. Yet... I hoped that the pumpkin patch would deter your progress Apparently not. I must admit that I'm intrigued as to how you arrived here. I was certain I'd weeded out your kind before sleep overtook me. Meat secretions hang in the air around your body. They offend my senses.
My God, what are you?
I am beyond your understanding, human. However, you may call me what the children do. Mother.
Oh, okay, hi, Mother. The scent of meat secretion surrounds me. Alright, so she's trying to protect her children from, I guess, a plague that seems to come from adults, it sounds like. God. She grew out of the metallic object that came from the sky, I think.
Mother! I should call you what you are, nothing but a disease!
Mind your tongue, human. I am more parent to these seedlings than you or anyone else could be.
The seedlings?
These aren't your seedlings, they're children. Flesh and blood, don't you see that?
I see, and it disgusts me. Animal sacks filled with loose cells. It's a wonder you don't burst. What an inferior vessel for the spirits of these children.
Inferior vessel? Okay, so Mother has a bit of a superiority complex.
But why have you done this?
The children were in danger.
Danger from what? You've done more harm than...
Than what? You? The mate called Jedha showed me how harmful your kind can be, as did the one called Preacher.
I'm guessing the Preacher's never coming back then. Or Jedha. What did they do?
Jedha. I saw his name on the pumpkin patch sign. What does he have to do with all this?
He made me see the evil of your kind. How destructive you are. Jedha preyed upon his own child, making her suffer and die. The entire town turned a blind eye to Jedha's crimes, and I watched. The people's vicious disregard for Carol's safety was no less a crime than her father's.
So you killed them?
Their own inner chaos would have destroyed them eventually. I only expedited the event, set things in order.
Wow, so she's a total hypocrite. She's worried... She's disgusted by the parents abusing their children. Rightfully so. But then what does she do? She punishes the children by making them stay in the pumpkin patch, where one of the girls had her eyes pecked out. What do you call that if not abuse?
Why were you so concerned about Carol?
She talked to me when no one would listen. I tried to communicate with them, but Carol's voice was like music to me. She was my favorite, and I failed her.
How does the Preacher figure into all of this? What could he possibly have done?
He was a superstitious fool. He spread paranoia and fear, swaying the others away from rational thought. The humans put their trust and faith in him and followed. When the Preacher assured them that Jedha wasn't a real threat to Carol, they listened.
Oh. Well, he did actually do something bad then. He used his powers to ensure that no one believed anything bad was going on. Still, absolutely none of that justifies anything that Mother has done.
If you're as omnipotent as you seem to think you are, then why haven't you weeded me out also?
In due time, little meat. For now you are of little consequence to me.
My name is Max, not Meat.
Your name is meaningless. An animal noise. And you are nothing more than a bag of meat.
If you truly feel that way, then why have you spared the children? Aren't they meat too?
Yes, and you have seen them bickering and divided. Yet, they are not beyond hope. The children still have some innocence, which, with some reconstructing on the cellular level, I will cultivate in order to give them salvation.
And you think that you can offer them salvation? What conceit?
It is not conceit. After I complete their transformation, the children will be one with me forever. That is their salvation.
Transforming them into simple plants? You call that salvation?
Simple plants! Insolent meat! You know what your problem is. You lack structure. The cells in your body are practically floating away. It makes me sick to look at you. Everything around you is in chaos. My form is superior in every way to your weak flesh.
Really? Your form is superior in every way. Okay, why don't you try walking out the door then? Oh, you can't move.
If my flesh is so weak, then why are you afraid of me?
Afraid of you? You overestimate yourself.
I think you're the one who overestimates yourself, you perverse, bloated egomaniac.
You impudent wretch!
I've got to kill that diseased monster before it kills the children.
Gotta say, so far, I'm really impressed with this game. That character, the mother, and the writing of her dialogue and all of that is brilliant. It's such a freaking weird character. But so detailed, too. She has her own motivations, and they actually make sense. You know, she's not just like some evil monster. She has her own motivations. She's actually a full-fledged character. A disgusting and bizarre character, but she's a character nonetheless. A fascinating one. And the writing is so good, too. If you notice, she uses a lot of language that is kind of plant-based, right? Like cultivate and seedlings and stuff like that. I'm really impressed. I did not expect that at all. That is just so cool. All right. So I think I need to electrocute her or something. But I need gas, and I don't know how to get that.
Looks like a barn.
Alright, well, completing the hide-and-seek game will get me the keys to, what was it, the general store or something like that? The storeroom or something of the sort. And I'm betting that the storeroom would probably have common supplies, which would allow me to get gas. You know, a cup and a tube or something like that. So I'm guessing I need to complete the hide-and-seek game before I can do anything here. And the question is, where the hell are the other children? And the answer is, I don't know. So, that's the next thing I need to do, and right now I don't think I have anything other
jumper
than
jumper cables.
other than jumper cables. And I can't think of what to do with them. I'm guessing I probably connect them to the generator to kill her. So I don't think I need to do anything with that yet, so I don't know where to go next. But I'm gonna figure it out. And when I do, I will be back, so I'll be back in just a second. Oh, well, hello. It only took me about 10 seconds after the cut to find one of the other children. I saw him poking his head up out of this barrel. Hello?
There you are.
He just exploded out of the barrel. How did he even fit in the first place? Jeez. Alright, is that the last one? I think it might be. How did he even fit? I think that might be the last one. Alright, who'd I talk to? Dennis? Oh, there we go. Oh, let's talk about Mother first.
I know about Mother. I've seen her. She's not human. Don't you understand what she...
Mother is good. Mother is the way. She protects us from the meat who would harm us. The meat must be killed so that the seedlings can grow. We're all Mother's seedlings.
Seedlings? But you're a child. A human child.
Shut up, mister. I know what she's doing and I don't care. Mother was right. She said you adults would try to ruin things. I don't want to talk to you anymore. So you just leave me alone or I'll shoot you with my slingshot.
Okay, I pissed Dennis off. Yeah, I just want to talk about that. I just want to talk about Mother some more, actually. It's such an interesting character and such an interesting concept. It's like some perverse alien creature has come from space, landed on the planet. From the... Oh, you know what that thing probably is? It's a freaking seedling. It's a seed. A gigantic, perverse seed. Yeah, that's why the vines are shooting out of it, right? It germinated. That's just such a... Oh, it's such a brilliant idea. This strange alien creature, seedling that came from outer space, landed on Earth, grew into something horrible, and started manipulating the children to her will. She's something that's, she's disgusted with human flesh and is trying to turn these moldable children into more plant-based forms. It's brilliant!
Huh, that wasn't so tough. I found everyone in one fair and square. Now give me the key to the store.
You big dolt! You forgot about our secret weapon!
What? The hell are you talking about?
I should have known you would cheat. What kind of crap are you trying to pull?
Hey, don't get upset, mister. I told you the rules. I told you about the secret weapon, and you didn't win.
What are you talking about? I found all of you.
You didn't find all of us.
What? What, is someone invisible?
What?
You didn't find Carol. She's our secret weapon. She's the best there is at this game. She's been hiding a long time.
Carol? Who? Where the hell am I gonna find Carol? I know, I recognize the name. I forgot exactly who she is. Is she dead, or what? The mother. Or Mother mentioned her, but... Okay. How... She's been hiding a long time.
Oh, not there either. Boy, are you stupid.
Who is Carol? I forgot, unfortunately. She's not like the corpse in here, is she? Wait, are any of these Carol?
Headstone.
No.
It says, Mike N. killed by tainted meat.
And this one's Driscoll, right?
See Driscoll. Yeah. Missed dearly by Mother.
Oh. Oh, see Driscoll. Is that Carol? Carol Driscoll?
A decaying corpse.
Do I have to dig her up?
Jumper cables.
I couldn't even if I wanted to. I don't have a shovel, but oh my god, I wouldn't want to even if I could. Any tools in here? Don't think so. No. Hmm. Okay, well, let me work at this a bit more, and I will be right back. Alright, welcome back. I think I found the solution. Remember C. Driscoll, which I think is Carol Driscoll, in the cemetery? And I thought, well, maybe I could dig her up. I wouldn't want to, but maybe I could if I had a shovel, but I didn't have one? What is this I see before me?
Looks like you're all done planting your seeds. Can I borrow your shovel now?
Go ahead, I'm all done. Mother will be so proud of me when she wakes up.
Not there either.
Oh my god, am I seriously going to dig up the corpse of a child? What the fuck?
C. Driscoll, missed dearly by mother.
Am I actually going to do this? This is horrible.
Jumper cable, shovel.
Oh god, here we go. Wow.
Oh my god. This decayed child must be Carol, Dennis's secret weapon.
Wow, I actually just did that. I just dug up the corpse of a child to win a game. Wow. This game is seriously twisted and dark.
What's your name?
Well, since all the...
I didn't actually mean to talk to him. I thought I was going to do something with Carol's body. Goodbye? Is that seriously where you're taking her? You're not gonna put her all the way over here? Okay. Dennis, I beat your game, and now I feel terrible about myself.
Alright, you twisted little freak. I dug up your secret weapon. Satisfied? Now hand over the keys.
Aw, man. You suck! Here's your damn keys.
Thanks, Dennis.
Wow, that is really disturbing. Like, genuinely disturbing. Alright, well, that's the only locked thing, so this has gotta be it. Whoops.
Jumper kick.
Okay. Well, this looks like quite the storage room.